अस्सलाम वालेकुम। दिस वीक यू विल बी परफॉर्मिंग एक्सपेरिमेंट नंबर 7 एंड दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट इज रिलेटेड टू पॉइंटर्स, अरेज एंड रिकर्शन। इन टास्क नंबर 1 यू हैव टू एलिमिनेट ऑल द सिंटैक्स एंड लॉजिकल एरर्स प्रेजेंट इन दिस कोड एंड एलिमिनेट ऑल ऑफ देम सो दैट यू गेट दिस आउटपुट ओवर हेयर। A variable a has been defined and initialized to value 10, while at this line a variable aptr is to be defined and initialized correctly so that it becomes a pointer to this variable a. So aptr will basically contain the address of a. In this for loop, the value pointed by aptr is being updated or incremented by 1, and after incrementing the value of the variable a pointed by aptr, that value is being printed at the output as shown over here. So there are some errors present over here. Try to correct them so that you get these integers printed vertically at the output. In the last line, the address that is present in this variable aptr is being printed at the output. So this is basically the address that is stored in this pointer aptr, and the value that is being pointed by this pointer is also to be displayed at the output. So 20, which is the last value of variable a, is to be printed at the output through pointer aptr. So you have to use aptr, not a, to print the value 20 at the output. So in this task you have to increment the value of a and display the value of a indirectly through pointer aptr. So eliminate all of these logical and syntax errors present in this code to get the correct output. Okay, in task number 2, you have to convert the following pseudocode into C code, and the purpose of this code is to find the cube of a number using pass by reference concept. So in pass by reference concept, pointers are passed as, or addresses are passed as arguments to the function being called while the program runs. In step number 1, you have to define and initialize an integer type variable, and the name of the variable should be kept i, and it should be initialized to value 10. You can initialize it to any value, but for this task it should be initialized to 10. In the second step, you have to call a function cube. The name of the function is cube, which basically takes the address of the variable I defined in step number 1. So the argument of that function will be the address of this variable I defined in step number 1. So say for example, in the main body you will call function cube. So when you will call this function cube, the argument of this function should be the address of the variable I. Okay, now this address is to be passed to the pointer aptr defined in the prototype of the function cube. So when you will create and define function cube after the main body, so aptr will be basically the pointer. So this is function prototype, this is function prototype, and this function prototype contains pointer aptr, and the address which you will write over here, the address of I will be basically passed to this pointer aptr. So I have ignored the data type of aptr. Similarly, what will be the data type of this cube, that should be determined by you people. So this is the meaning of line number 2. Okay, so in step number 3, you have to print the cube of the value stored in variable I. So you can see at this output, this message should be printed. The cube of the number is 1000, and that's it. It's a short code. So what is the algorithm of the function cube? What is the algorithm? What should be written in the body of this function cube? So it's pretty straightforward. The algorithm is the value pointed by aptr. The value pointed by aptr is equal to the value pointed by aptr multiplied by value pointed by aptr multiplied by value pointed by aptr. So nothing is to be returned back, because pass by reference procedure automatically updates the value of I. So go through the lecture given by Dr. Irfan, lecture number 4, to understand the concept of pass by reference. Okay, in task number 3, you have to complete the following code. So you have to complete this code to get this output. So this code will ask the user to enter his or her name, and the maximum number of characters that can be entered by the user is 5, and then this code is prompting the user to enter his or her marks 3 times. And after doing that, the name of the user is printed in reverse order and the marks are printed horizontally with space in between each of the marks. Okay, so at line number 10, write the 2 missing elements in scanf statement. So at line number 10, you can see that there are 2 missing elements over here. You have to determine those 2 missing elements so that the user could enter his name or her name properly, and that name is to be stored in this array A. So, and this array A has 5 maximum number of elements, and the data type of this array is character. step 2. 914 to 17 prompts the user to enter his her marks 3 times. So you can see that this for loop is responsible to take the marks from the user and store it in array B one by one. So the user will enter his or her marks one at a time, and each marks will be stored in array B. So array B is defined to contain maximum 3 elements. So say for example, if I have array B with 3 elements, 1, 2, and 3, so this is array B. So the first element is 10. 10 will be stored over here. The second element is 11. 11 will be stored here, and the third element is 12, and 12 will be stored at this location of array B. So this is basically B0. This is B1, and this location is B2. This should be small b. So the marks are to be stored in array B, and this for loop is responsible to do that task. Okay, at step number three, complete the for loop at line. Okay, so at step number three, complete this for loop. So a function print is defined over here, and the purpose of this print function is to print the name in reverse order and to print the marks entered by the user. So these two lines will be printed by this function. So complete this for loop. This for loop is responsible to print the name of the user in reverse order. Start from j is equal to 5. Do not change this. Fill the missing elements and determine what should be written over here so that the username is printed in reverse order. Okay, another for loop is to be used to display the marks stored in array B. So the marks which we have stored in array B should be displayed at the output using for loop. Now where to place this for loop? Should that for loop be placed here, 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 or somewhere over here? That should be determined by you people. And that's it. At step number 5, do not change anything at line 2 and 22. So line 2 basically contains the prototype of the function print, and do not change anything over here. Similarly, do not change anything in this function header. So sometimes in the function definition, this is function definition. In function definition, the very first line is also called header of the function. So this is called function prototype, and this is called header of the function. Okay, in this task, you have to determine the output of this code without using computer, and you have to determine the output for x is equal to 5 and y is equal to 3. So this code will basically take two inputs from the user and then display some number which is which will be determined by this function mystery. So you can see that this function mystery calls itself over here, and that is why this is called recursion. In recursion, a function calls itself single or multiple times. So try to solve this without using computer for x is equal to 5 and 3 and y is equal to 3. And after doing this task manually, verify this using computer. Okay, in this task, you have to write a C code to swap the value of two variables. So, say for example, 5 is stored in variable A and 10 is stored in variable B, then this code should transfer 10 to variable A and value 5 to variable B, and the output should look like this. So before swapping, the value of A is 5 and B is 10, and after swapping, the value of A is 10 and B is 5. This is similar to the code which we have seen before in experiment number 6. So in experiment number 6, you can see that this portion of the code actually swaps the values stored in array element di and array element di plus 1. So if we have array say d, and if this is di, and this is di plus 1, then this code will swap the elements present in di and di plus 1. Similar procedure can be used to swap the values present in variables, say for example A and B. So if A is equal to 5 and say B is equal to 10, then the same procedure can be used to swap the values of the two variables. Now in this task, you have to swap the values present in both the variables, but the main thing is you have to use pointers. So you will be using pointers, you will be using pointer to A, which can be say APTR, and you will be using pointer to variable B, which can be named as BPTR, and by using APTR and BPTR and following this procedure, you have to swap the values present in variable A and variable B.